Today is a very enjoyable day. Today is the feast of a great saint. And we are very proud and honored to be in his monastery, the monastery of Saint Shenouda. So today is the feast of the patron of our monastery, Saint Amba Shenouda the Great. As you know, that Saint Shenouda, the original, goes back up to the 4th century. Up to the 4th century, imagine, 1800 years ago. And we still talk about him. Isn't that amazing? He's not forgettable. 1800 years ago, even more. And we still talk about him and how great he is. And this is how it works. When someone really loves God, God always brings him up. And he makes him great. Make him very great. Not forgettable. We might forget lots of kings and queens. And we can forget the most famous singers or whatever, footballers or whatever. They're not that important. People forget them just like that. But imagine until now, you can sit down. Until now we talk about Saint Shenouda. Until now we talk about Saint Damiana, Saint Justina, Saint George. All these saints going back to the 4th or the 5th century, and we still remember them. Because they are great people, they are honest people, very faithful people. They deserve to have their names being mentioned everywhere. Everywhere. Saint Shenouda originally started where? In Egypt. Now we have Saint Shenouda even in Australia. Imagine. From Egypt, from Said to Australia. We still talk about him. We are very grateful to have this beautiful monastery here in Sydney. We are very grateful to those who really toiled very much and they thought about the idea of having a monastery here in Australia. Lots of people worked very hard to buy the land, to do the buildings, to work hard to make it a successful one. We are very grateful to have beautiful fathers, monks, who are living in this beautiful place. And we enjoy the blessing of Saint Shenouda every day with us in this beautiful monastery. And for this, I want to thank very much all those who really work very hard in this monastery. May God reward you all. The Gospel of today is a beautiful Gospel from the book of St. Mark. Did you notice? What a beautiful Gospel. It was from the book of St. Mark, chapter 9, from 31 to 41. Mark 9, 31 to 41. Only 10 verses. It is talking about what? Talking about who is the greatest. Shkoda? Who is the greatest? Man huwa al-a'zam. You know, the Lord Jesus Christ had his 12 disciples and they were having, you know, a dispute, a quarrel between them. They want to know who is the greatest among them, the 12. And you know, this is always, it's a desire in all our hearts. I want to be the greatest. I want to be the best. I want to be the most famous. Yes, Allah, the greatest. It's easy to say, I want to be the greatest. But are you the greatest? So they were talking and fighting between themselves. Who is the greatest? Was it Matthew or was it James? Or was it Bartholomew? They were fighting. So the Lord knew what's in their minds. He called him, Alam ta'ala habib indahu. You want to be the greatest? I will tell you how to be the greatest. If you want to be the greatest, you have to be what? Last of all, and what? Servant of all. You have to be what? last of all and servant of all. Is this how we think about it? Or we don't think about these things. We want to trample on top of each other and kick everybody, push everybody, because I'm the best. I'm the first. Who cares about others? But this is not the right way. And this is not the correct way. So the Lord today said, if you want to be the greatest, it's good. It's good to be the greatest. But how? If you want to be the greatest, you should do what? You should be the last of all and what? Servant of all. If you do this, you're going to be the greatest and nothing else. But pushing people and trampling over them because you don't want anybody to be, you know, in the picture, only you, then you are the most dumb person. Not the greatest, the most dumb person. And you'll get nowhere. You'll go nowhere. People will kick you also out. And nobody will mention your name. Nobody will love you. Nobody will respect you because you are a very selfish person. You are what? Selfish person. And selfish person will never going to be the best. But a humble person, a loving person, a serving person, he is the greatest. People will love him more. People will always love to, you know, bring him and bring him forward and tell everybody about him because he is humble. He is not looking for his own what? Pride or his own self. No. He does everything. He does the best. But at the end of the day, he's not there. He's not in the picture. Maybe he can push somebody else to do the last part of the job so that people can see them doing the job that he, although he did 99% of the job, but he is disappearing. He doesn't want to have a show off. But people will bring him, tell him, you are the best. And even the Lord Jesus Christ gave us an example before. He said, when you go to a party, or when you go to an occasion, or you go to a very special celebration, when you go there, where do you sit? He said, go and sit at the back there. Sit at the back there. And when the owner or the host of this celebration, they see you sitting at the back there, they say, no, please come forward. They bring you forward and they put you in front of everybody. So you've been sitting down there at the back because you don't think highly of yourself. But the people know who you are and they bring you to the front. But if you are someone who is very arrogant and have a very big head, and you think that you are the greatest, and you are the most important than everybody else in this celebration, and then you come and you sit where? In the front. This is not your place. And then the person in charge will come and tell you, please, could you come with me? You're supposed to sit there at the back. And in the middle of everybody, they take you and they push you and put you back there. How would you feel? You're going to feel very embarrassed. So why from the beginning, why you thought that highly of yourself? Yeah. Who are you? Yeah. تطلع مين انت اصلا؟ ما تقعد ورا وتسكت. لكن هو فضح نفسه وكسف نفسه. لكن ربنا قال when you go to such a celebration, sit at the back. And if you're really that worthy and if you're that really important person, then the people will come and then bring you up, bring you to the front. And if you're not, then they're going to push you back again. So here, Habibi, think humble of yourself. Even if you are really the good person, even if you have done the best, think humbly and think that you are the last of all. You are the servant of all. Then God will exalt you. It is God who is going to bring you up. But you don't bring yourself up. You should only think very lowly of yourself. You have to do your right, you have to do the job and do everything right and fully and expert and in an expert way and in a professional way, you do it right. And then also think of others. Think of others. What you can do for others, not yourself only, being selfish. Think of others. So today's motto, the motto of today, is what? If you want to be the greatest, be what? Last of all and servant of all. Very simple, isn't it? And don't think highly of yourself, but think of others. May God bless you and be with you and make you all great people. Not just great, but the greatest. I'd love to see you the greatest. But in the eyes of God, not in the eyes of people. I don't care what people say. But in the eyes of God, that's number one. Today, in this beautiful occasion of the feast of Saint Shenouda, God and Saint Shenouda is bringing a gift for us. He's bringing to us a beautiful young man called Mina. Come forward. Brought this young man to join the monastery in such a beautiful occasion. Mina and his beautiful family, they are all here today. They're having his dad, Makram, Mama Teresa, or sister Lillian, or brother Philo. They all came driving all the way from Melbourne to Sydney, so they can be with us in this beautiful occasion. And today, we can't find any more beautiful occasion than the Feast of Saint Shenouda to have Mina starting with us. So today, Mina is going to be in KG1, the KG1. So could you bring your dress? I'm going to change his name. I know Mina is a beautiful name, but I want to give him a new name. Guess what? You have any guess? Did you listen to the Sinixar today? The Sinixar of today, when Asyodor was reading the Sinixarium. Two saints. Number one was who?
Ignatius.
Saint Shenouda, and the other one?
Ignatius.
Ignatius. Ignatius. Ignatius. So I'm going to give him the name Ignatius today. He's going to be called Ignatius from now. Brother Ignatius. A great saint. I love him. A great man. They said to him, we want you to ignore or deny your Lord Jesus Christ. He said, no, I'm going to be like wheat, you know, wheat, to be grinded so we can make bread for Christ. I'm willing even to suffer for Christ, to be grinded like wheat, we make ni'mal biha, like urban and bread. Isn't that amazing? So they brought him to the lions. The lions attacked him, but they could not eat him. They couldn't dare to come and eat him. Yes, they attacked him and they killed him, but they couldn't touch him. So they killed him and they left, and the people came and took the body and buried him. But anyhow, it's a beautiful saint called Saint Ignatius. So today I'll give the name to Ignatius, to Mina, to be Ignatius from now on. Okay?
Hey.
his confession father, Abuna Elijah from Melbourne, sent me a very beautiful recommendation letter. Very, very beautiful recommendation. And I'm very proud to hear that about him. And also Abuna Abanub is very happy, and he's saying Makum Babruk, congratulations. And Abuna Athanasius Atiyah also sent a beautiful message saying Mabruk li little brother. وبعدين أمبا أشعيا كان معي في التلفون امبارح. He's very happy again for the brother. يقول مبروك عليكم. إن شاء الله we're gonna have more new young people joining, إن شاء الله. بس we do it step by step. At the same time, بابا هنا وماما عندهم كده هدية حلوة. كل دي عم بيكتبوها زي دي عم. بيكتبوها بفراق كده. دي هدية هم جايبينها معاهم من ملبون all the way. ممكن نطلع كده هنا شوية. So beautiful. شكر. طبعا دي احنا لما هنعمل لها كده درعيه ونحطها فيها ان شاء الله. الف مبروك.